Hello and welcome to Phantom Hourglass. Is it supposed to be showing?
Yeah.
Is it not?
Yeah.
There you go. What's that? You wanted to see this one? Oh, there you go. There you go. You wanna see that one instead? You wanna see that one? Welcome, everybody. The Legend of Zelda Phantom Hourglass. Now, I wanna be clear. I have never played this game. I've never touched this game. I don't know. I know almost nothing about this game. I know roughly what our companion character looks like. That's almost it. I also know that it's very touchscreen based. That's actually it. I know what our companion character looks like. I don't know anything about them. And I know that it's touchscreen based. This is a very touchscreen heavy game. I don't know anything else. That's it. So, this is, out of the entirety of the Zelda games, out of every single one of them, I actually know nothing. This is the one that I know the least. I meant to pause this. Give me a second. I actually know the least right now out of this game. Every single other Zelda game that we're going to be doing down the line, I know more about than this game. This is the one that I know almost nothing about. I've played the train one a little bit. So, like, us going into this, this is almost entirely a blind playthrough. Which doesn't exist for the rest. Because, like, I know almost nothing about some of the other games, but I still know more about them than this one. Okay? So this is going to be a very interesting playthrough. Quack is assuming that I'm going to hate this. It's possible that I won't, because my expectations are so ungodly low for this game. My expectations are so minimal that, like, it is possible that I enjoy this game simply because I expect so little. This might be, other than the CDI games, this might be the most hated Zelda game. It's at least bottom. It's somewhere down there at the bottom. Like, this might be the most hated Zelda game. So, like, it is... So, like, my expectations are so minimal that, like, it's possible that I love this simply because I have such low expectations, you know? You know what I mean? So, anyways, I made a test account called Testicle. I realize my controller isn't working. We'll have to fix that in a second. We're gonna name our, for the VOD watchers, we're gonna name our character, and then we're gonna jump in, okay? Okay. I got one more thing before we go. We're playing this game with a banana. That is all. Alright, cool. I have been informed that this is, maybe the same link from the last game, to some degree. I don't know. I don't know. So in turn, we're from Wind Waker, I mean. So we're naming him Splunk, which is the same name that he is in Wind Waker. Is it yes? You hold the stylus in your right or left hand? Right. You use your right hand? Yes. Alright, so we got Testicle and Splunk.
Our story begins not long ago. There was a young girl, savvy to the seas and head of a band of pirates. Her name was Tetra. She was pretty, brash, and brave. Tetra and her handsome pirates set out to explore the vast and unfamiliar seas. One day, on a stop at an island, Tetra met a young boy dressed in green. After a series of strange events, the two began traveling together. They found old ruins and light enveloped Tetra. At once, she transformed into a beautiful princess who also was whitewashed, her lineage traced back to an ancient ruined kingdom. She was Princess Zelda of the kingdom Hyrule. Just then, a huge, ominous king appeared. He carried Princess Zelda away. The evil king sought the sacred power passed down to Hyrulean princesses. He schemed to take the power and use it himself. The boy chased after him, determined to save the princess.
I know, that's why I didn't do it, Quack.
The boy crossed seas and climbed mountains. The journey was perilous. He slayed evil monsters and used their power to become a true hero. After long and hard adventuring, he defeated the evil king. And beautiful Princess Zelda was rescued at last.
I'll recap the other Zelda games after this cutscene, okay?
Later, the two set out with the brave pirate crew in search of new lands. Yes, they set sail together. A happy pirate ending.
Hey, so what did you think of my amazing paper cutouts?
I don't remember what voice I gave him. I know it was somewhere around here. My controller's not working. Interesting. Oh, there we go.
Did you guess that Tetra was really Princess Zelda? Hey, Sploink, are you sleeping, Swabby? Sploink! Sploink!
Oh.
Sploink! Stop messing around there. You're both supposed to be on lookout.
Oh, it is working.
Some legendary hero you are. Who believed you'd save me from the evil king? Princess Zelda, we're nearly at that spot of the sea. I told you not to call me Zelda. Tetra worked just fine before, you know. But enough about that. So this is where the ghost ship is said to appear. Stay on the lookout for the creepy-looking ship.
Are you sure this is a good idea? What about all those ships that have been gone missing and stuff? I say the ghost ship is behind it all.
Right, Nico. Every ship disappears. And it's all because of that scary ghost ship.
Hey, Tetra. They say these seas are protected, yeah? Something about a spirit called the Ocean King. Wouldn't a spirit like that protect the ships? Unless they're ghost... Unless their ghost really is a evil ghost ship.
Unless they're... Wouldn't that be not... That? Oh no, I missed the is. It's me. I made the mistake.
Unless there really is an evil ghost ship.
I missed the is.
Don't be ridiculous. There's no such thing as a ghost ship. I bet it's just some pirates up to no good. I'll expose them as a bunch of frauds. and remind them that there are rules to being pirates. I doubt there really is an Ocean King anyway.
Hey, look! The air feels chilly. Eerie even. I say we take a detour around this creepy place.
Quit being so scared. We're here to see the world, not take detours.
Ship ahoy! I remember his voice.
Tetra, I can see a ship. Yes, a ship up ahead.
It's the ghost ship! These waters really are cursed!
You call yourself a pirate? It's just a ship! But it does look like it could be the ghost ship. There might even be a load of treasure on board. I'm gonna get to the bottom of this.
Yeah, you need to keep in mind.
Save me, Sploy.
You can wait. Am I gonna do this again? Am I gonna put myself through this again? I guess I am. I'm gonna put myself through it again.
Oh, phew! You're awake! You're a mummy! So I thought you were done for!
She's a Boston now.
What? It looks like you're gonna be okay!
That's how you know it's not Navi and or the one from Majora's Mask that I don't remember the name of. Tattle.
I'm Ciela! You see, I'm a fairy. I was out floating around and I found you here. What happened?
Huh?
What? A ghost ship? Your friend was taken away by a ghost ship? And you got separated from your own ship, huh? Is it the ghost ship people have been talking about? They say that those it takes are never seen again. You want to know more about the ghost ship? Grandpa will know all about it. I lost my memory a long time ago. I woke up on this page.
What's going on? Do you see that? Okay, I'm good.
I woke up on this page. Grandpa rescued me. He's, very sweet. So, you got nothing to worry about. up there, off the beach. Come on. Can you walk? Not the direction you want to move your stylus.
Wait, it's tap? Oh. I see. Yeah, so you need to keep in mind that this game is on the bottom screen right now. This game is being rendered, so like the 3DS, hang on, or the DS rather. Keep in mind that the DS had two screens, right? They're a little dirty, don't mind. Had two screens, right? And the bottom screen, this is a DSi, so it's bigger. Or a DSXL, rather. So, like, the bottom screen had a much lower resolution than the top screen. It ditched resolution and graphical prowess on the bottom screen so that they could have the technology of the touch screen. This entire game, so far, other than the map, is being rendered exclusively on the bottom screen. So in turn, the graphics that this game has are like nowhere near what they could be at the time because it's on the bottom screen, not the top. But in reality, this is the top screen. The map is being rendered on the top screen right now. This is the bottom screen. Also, we're also rendering this at a higher resolution just to be front facing with it. We're seeing this in 4K resolution right now. In reality, it would look like this. Now we can do this if y'all want. I wanted to give the option. We can do this. It makes it pixel art instead. Would you guys rather have the what we had before? Or would you rather have the pixel art? You're saying nopers that didn't answer my question. Would you rather have the pixel art or the more what we had before? The 4K. And that. We also can go somewhere in the middle. This is 8 times, this is 4 times. Yeah, it kind of does the do like this. Do like this. How's this, chat? You like this? Still has like the rough pixely edges. What do you think? Want HD? Well, it is HD all the same. It's HD. Whoops. It's the HD regardless. What do I want? This is my first time playing. What do I want? At this. I think that this looks the best out of them. It still has like the rough edges like it's pixel art, but it is a little bit more clear. I'm also going to change something on your guys' side real quick. Because I see something different than you guys, and I'll show you that in a second. Hang on. Am I changing what I think I'm changing? Yeah, okay. So I'm actually, I know they're paused. It's intentional. So I'm actually seeing something different than you guys. You guys are seeing, you guys are seeing this, all right? This is how you guys are witnessing this game, right? And I can change, what monitor y'all are looking at. Didn't know I could do that. I can change which of the screens is your priority, right? So this is what you guys see. This isn't what I see. I see this. This is what I'm looking at. I chose to do it in this way so that we could get the highest resolution possible so that I could scale it up and look like this. Because I know that this game is primarily going to be one screen at a time. So I chose to do it this way so that you guys could get a higher resolution out of the game. We're also playing on a banana. One more thing before we get started here. That recap recapped Wind Waker. There's more lore than just Wind Waker, and we know that because we've been playing the game so far, right? So for the whole series, right, you already got Wind Waker. That is the one game in this branch of the timeline, other than Tingle's game, which doesn't really matter. It's just Tingle collecting rubies. So there's actually more that you need to know. In Skyward Sword, a cycle was started where every single unprecedented amount of time, three people got revived and resurrected in order to once again do battle over the Triforce. These people were Demise, reskinned as Ganon later. Princess Zelda, who is a reincarnation of the goddess Hylia herself, and the legendary human hero, Link, later Hylian. These three people are being revived throughout time and generations because of their connection to the Triforce. For a while, it was just Link and Zelda being revived, where they were doing battle with a evil wind wizard named Vati. But then Ganon entered the mix once again with Ocarina of Time, where he and Link fought to bring peace. After Ganon was defeated in the adult timeline, after an unprecedented amount of time, Link eventually died, and no one was there to defend the Kingdom of Hyrule anymore. This was after they rebuilt Hyrule Castle and reestablished the kingdom, right? But Link wasn't around anymore to defend the kingdom, and in turn, Ganon tried to take the castle, tried to get to the Master Sword to basically unleash the last part of his soul to gain full power in order to take over the kingdom once again, like he did in Ocarina of Time. However, the sages who were present in Ocarina of Time chose to seal the Master Sword within a sanctum within the castle, and then seal the castle in a bubble of time, and then flood the entirety of Hyrule, effectively murdering millions. But saved like a couple dozen. So that's cool. Then the events of Wind Waker happen, then the Tingle game, and now you're caught up. That's all you need to know. Alright, now that you're all caught up, now that we're all on the same page, now we can play Phantom Hourglass, okay? Okay, and I love you too, dude. Now we can play Phantom Hourglass. So as you notice, the shadows are a little glitchy. They're like a clipping texture. No matter what I change, that happens regardless. So we're just gonna have to deal. It's not, like, so insane that it's epileptic. We're just gonna have to deal. It is what it is.
Hello there, friend. Try tapping on me. Yep, that's how it's done. Just tap on people to speak with them. Try tapping on other things like signs and barrels.
If at any point the screens are on the wrong thing, chat, yell at me. Can I take the bird inside? That's a shame. How are you doing stylus controls? My mouse. A banana. I've heard there's a ghost ship on the prowl again, stealing more islanders. So very dangerous. Monster? What? Monster? Banana? Yeah, I'm controlling with a banana. That lady's face? Ah, she's fine. Hi, Usa, how are you? One thing out of the way? Hell yeah. This is now as far as I played testing the game. Doing a little better? Good. Keep on the up and up. No, I'm playing on a completely legal system.
Hey, hello, traveler. So your name is Splunk. I'm Osius. I live on this island. Ciela, you told me what happened to you. I also hear your friend was taken by a ghost ship. I understand that you want to find a ghost ship, but you must not.
But Grandpa, what are you saying? Spike's friend was carried away.
Pure evil. Pure evil feels sad to the ghost ship. It roams the seas in search of victims to capture it. No one has ever escaped from it. It's best for you to stay away from that ghost ship. No, to seek out that ship is to seek out your doom. That's why we have to do something.
Grandpa?
Oh, mercy me.
Hang on, I want to see something. Experimentation is important to understand what you like and dislike.
To the east of here.
Right there.
A sailor by the name of Lineback should be there. He'll be waiting to tell you more about the ghost ship. Look at your map. The harbor's there.
So many of my friends' art styles were inspired by this game back in school.
Man, that guy who came to visit Grandpa? He asked about the ghost ship. I remember him. I'll go with you, Spike, and show him who he is. It's okay, right, Grandpa?
Yeah, I don't see why you can't go. I'm sure you can help, Spike.
Thank you, Grandpa. Let's go, Spike.
He's always been an antsy one. Yeah. Now, Splunk, lately there have been some many monster sightings. I gave in to you and told you about I'm back. But you be careful out there.
Okay. How are you feeling about the overlays and chat stuff? What? How are you feeling about the overlays and stuff, chat?
What's that rumbling? Another earthquake? So many quakes as lately. There's so many monsters. Bad signs for sure. And I bet there are even worse things to come.
Very good. Oh. Is the blur in the back too dark or too bright, too distracting? How's the chat look?
Oh, heavens. That quake broke the bridge again. So many quakes lately. And the bridge breaks every time. There's a big one. There's a second way to get to the town, fortunately. Fortunately, it leads through a frightening cave full of monsters. Ain't what to do. Well, wait for the bridge to be fixed, of course.
Like a stone bridge. It's gonna take a long time to fix. Can I lift this rock? Oh my god, I'm ripped. Danger, monsters ahead. That's fun. It kind of bothers me that your camera frame is in the game. I feel like the blur is good. I like the camera frame. I intentionally did that. Can I pick up this chew? No, I just need to avoid it. I didn't do that.
Monsters, look out, Splunk! It's way too dangerous. You need something to defend yourself with. You have to go back!
This was intentional because I wanted to be part of the game's capture. I like things to be, I don't know, special. I don't know what the words I'm looking for. Yep, that's it. Yep, that's how it's done. You tap people. Anyway, I've had a bad bit of luck with my garden here. That's weird. What the fuck? How do you get here? Man, he creamed on me. That quake just heaved a bunch of rocks into the middle of my patch. Would you mind tapping on them? Simply tap on a rock to pick it up. And then tap where you want it to throw. Okay. My bad. Thanks a plenty. You really helped me out there. Not much, but here's some for your trouble. I insist. What's that dirty look? Think I'm a cheapskate? Fine, here's a hot tip. Look at your map. There's a tree on that spot. Go bash it really hard. I'd recommend that you, drop that down on your map before you forget it. Scribble on your map, tap the menu, then tap map. Menu, map. Ooh. Okay. There you go. There you go. Subscribe. Yeah. That's not where he said to go. You're right, it isn't. He said to go. He said to go here. Yeah. Perfect circle. All right. I'm gonna bust. Bia, how are you? I'm a goofy goober rock. Ding, bam, 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 ding, 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 ding. Whoa. Hey, thank you very much. Grandpa, you ain't crying.
Grandpa, use this cave as a storeroom.
Listen, I had to get another voice, all right? I'm old. It takes a little bit of time nowadays. Keep your hands off my things, please ask first, Oshus. Okay. Hey, can I have your things? You should fix that. There is no way to fix it.
Had a bad in order, did you? Ciela, don't pretend you forgot I told you never to go that way. We've seen so many quakes rattled on lately, Splunk. And the monsters have been seen closer and closer to town. We called, young ones, that cave up north leads to the port. True. But that path will be crawling with monsters. Don't even think of it. Yeah, I'm sure someone will get around there bearing the bridge.
Like, here's the sitch, alright? I'll run it down for you. So.
Well, Grandpa wants us to stay out of trouble, but we need to find your friend. If only you found a sword, then you could show those monsters.
So, like, here's the sitch. Here's where we're at, right? So you see it's doing its thing, right? Now, the theory was originally that's because of the up-resing. So I bring it down to where it's default, right? Still happens. Do that. Do that. Do that. Still happening. Honestly, chat, I think I'm gonna disagree with you. I like it like this. I think I'm gonna leave it like this. So then I was like, okay, let's try the other renderer mode and put it on software. That actually fixed the problem. It didn't fix it before. I swear to God it didn't fix it before. I swear to God. Was it because I had that turned on? I swear to God that didn't fix it before. I swear to you. I swear. I'm not lying. I swear to God that didn't fix it. All right, I guess we're running it like this. It fixed. It's fixed. I fixed it. I did it. Me. Yay. Hey, Eli, how are you? I found a way to watch the stream on the ferry. Have you taken a poop off the edge yet? Everyone give me your monies so I can buy expensive food on here. On the ferry? Ferry food? All right. We need to find a sword. He said that we need to wait until we can go that way. Can I roll? How do I roll? Not like that. Is it a button? No. Okay. Didn't I have a sword before? Shouldn't there be like a sword on the beach? Because like I had one. I guess it would have sank. So I lost my master sword. Oh, that sucks. What does that say? To the port. Oh, okay. Oh, same thing as before. Same thing as before. So I can't under any circumstances go this way. Oh no, I totally can. Fucking Ciela lied to me. Ciela made it seem like I'm not able to, but I totally can. Oh, I can't get through there though. What the fuck is that? Nothing, I guess. I can't get through there, so I do need a sword to cut through that. You didn't ask. I did. I went to him. I talked to him. Went to him. I talked to him, and he didn't say that I could. I have to talk to him a second time because he talked about the monsters. Do I need to talk to him again? But this time about the cave? He should have talked about it for the first time. Why does it take two times? Give me all the information I need, old man. See, this is why we should kill all old people. See? He said this. Same conversation we had before. Don't act like I'm in the wrong here, okay? I tried.
I can't remember Grandpa storing a sword back there. How to get this door open? I remember he cracks open the door by writing a number on that sign. I think he says it's, there are palm trees on the beach. Snakey.
Man, I don't think I can do this voice anymore. God damn, what's happening to me? Has my voice changed? Is my voice changing a second time? Are my balls dropping a second time? Can't swim. Got it. Have fun, dude, but not too much fun. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Balls dropped too. I mean, maybe my voice didn't get any deeper. I just can't do this voice anymore. I don't know what's happening to me. I'm my voice is cracking with every word. Hang on.
Testing, testing. 1, 2, 3. Whoa! Is it there yet? Now I try to do the Boston voice. It's the Boston accent.
I think it's the Boston accent. I think I can't do the Boston accent at the same time. Okay, can I write on the sign? Here we go. There was a girl crying in the bathroom stall next to me, so once I shitted, I asked her if she was okay or if she needed anything, and under her breath, she just says, "Fuck off." Yeah, she needed you to fuck off. Yeah. Well, you asked that after you filled the bathroom with your rank poopy smell. So, like, you know, she's probably upset that that you filled the bathroom with your rank smell as she was crying, all right? Using the sword, basics number one. Use the stylus to swing your sword. Tapping and drawing lines quickly is the key to deft swordplay. I'm gonna go talk to Grandpa after I steal his sword. Nice. You found a sword. Oh.
I found a sword. I shouldn't tell Grandpa. Taking it. He'd worry himself sick. Good for us, though. Now we can defend ourselves from those monsters.
Oh. I wanted to shake or stall and scream, it's your fault. Nightmare, nightmare, nightmare. Hell yeah. Nightmare, nightmare, nightmare. That's the way to go about it.
You two are proving to be quite a handful.
That wasn't his voice. Hey, he's an ashore. What are you planning on doing right?
Grandpa, I'm sorry. We just had to. We can't abandon his kidnapped friend. We can't wait for the bridge.
Yeah, I understand. But I can't just let you go. Now, Ashore, man, you know you gotta handle that sword. I'll teach you how to handle it. Meet me in my house.
Already now, I go, whoop. And I go, whoop. Going. Oh, I can't do that. Okay, alright.
If you have a sword, then know that even the best swords can be bad. Even mishandled, that is, so I must teach you the basics of sword play. Let's begin with the target attack. I'm gonna bring out some targets for sword practice. Far safer than real foes. Just tap a target to lock on and close in for an attack. Right now. Oh. Excellent. The target attack is the most basic attack. Use it well. Now for the side slash. When you find it hard to lock on enemies, use the side slash instead. Just sketch a line that divides you and your target slash at it. This move requires a little practice. Simply sketch a line slash. Oh.
Okay, so I can't do it while walking. Specifically like that.
Looks like you fully understand the side slash. You know how to use the slash several things at once. Remember it well. Finally, we have the spin attack. Fly the stylus in a circle around yourself. Superb. I can teach you nothing more. Now you must swim on your own as you venture out among the monsters. But if you do have any problems, turn here and speak with me.
Ooh. I've never been on a ferry. Walk into this. No, okay. It looked like he just stabbed it because I walked into it.
Oing, oing, oing. Want to do a somersault? Took up a tiny circle at the very edge of your screen. Roll into that big tree there to see you shake loose. Well, too much, however, you'll get dizzy.
Very edges of your screen. Like that? How the fuck? I don't understand. Very complex. Can't do it. I Well, I guess I'm not rolling in this game, because it's very difficult for me to do.
Give Eli money for burgies. I'm not asking politely.
If you asked me politely, I would have done it. Want to play Minecraft? Have fun. Not too much fun.
Give Eli money for burgies. I'm asking twice as politely.
Nope, you got one. You had one shot to ask me politely and you missed it. Hi, Squirrely. How are you? How's your stream? Someone shout out Squirrely, please. You got a small key. I can unlock a door. Nice. Welcome, everybody, to a vastly different game than what you were just watching. This is Phantom Hourglass, The Legend of Zelda Phantom Hourglass. This is the most hated Zelda game. It is bottom tier. Maybe not most hated, but it's definitely bottom tier. A lot of people don't like this game. However, also a lot of people like this game. Pull the four levers in the correct order, or else. Tap a block to grab it, then tap the arrows that appear to move it. I think the reason why people don't like this game, the theory, is because it is entirely touch controls for everything in the entire game. I think that's why. Someone took the cat I liked the most, left it outside, and it was lost forever. It'd be like that. Had a cat thrown. Now mass time next time. When pulling the levers, first, second from the left.
Oh, four levers? Who might those be, I wonder? Well, I bet this will come in handy. How about we write it on a map? Now that, tap the map icon and scribble it to your heart's content. Or just press down on the plus control pad. On the B button. Yay, shortcuts.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. We'll see. Good, Eli. Okay. Nice! I'm rich! When pulling the levers, first on the left. Oh, second, first on the left. Last, second from the right. Okay. So is it two? And then four? Is that what it said? Yeah. What is called Phantom Hourglass? I'll have to ask my friend if he's played it. I've never played it until now. My first time ever touching this game. I don't know nothing. Well, it looks like one of the rats has the key. Hey, James, how you doing? Oops. I see. What does this do? Oh, does it block off the way? Drew, when do we get pee break? Like 30 minutes? Just started, basically. Killed the shit out of that rat. I started this game a few years ago and got stuck 3/4 of the way in. Well, let's see if I get stuck. I can tell you one thing for sure. This looping song in this little cave fucking sucks. I can tell you that for sure. Like a 3-second loop, if even. That might be even exaggerating. That might be giving it too much credit. God damn. Why did you? I don't. Okay. Maybe I accidentally clicked it.
By the way, yeah. Well, let's look for Lineback. I met him once or twice. Can't say I care for him. He's awfully big talker for such a big cuckoo. Okay. Let's head to the port.
Not again. This crummy bridge breaks every time we have a quick. Hey, don't have time to keep on babysitting this thing. Not when the ship's in the need of fixing. But Ashu says that the bridges are just as important as the ships. When that old man tells you to do something, you do it, like it or not. And I don't like it, but I'll do it. Anything to avoid Ashu's nagging me all the time.
You don't have to do this. It doesn't hurt. I just can't do the voice anymore, apparently. Not as well, at least. But it doesn't hurt. If anything, that voice hurts more.
Welcome to Mercase Island Port.
Wait, no, I'm gonna do like a...
Welcome to Mercase Island Port. You'd normally see sailors coming and going. But rumors that the ghost ship have returned have all but shut down our harbor. If for one brave soul who recently docked his ship, that is.
Interesting. Interesting. I'm gonna turn this up a little bit. Yeah, that's as bright as it goes. I need to turn up my camera a little bit. Turn up my camera a little bit. Yeah, there we go. A bit better. Get a voice changer? Voice changer for people who can't do voices. Alright.
I can't wait to sit down and eat my bang up in a dress. Nigga, be tired. Nigga, wait here for a minute. Take a breather. I never enjoy in such a damn rush.
Is this a shop? Wood.
Welcome, shopper. How can I help you?
Wood.
Can I have the shield? It's a wooden shield. It protects you from light attacks, just 80 rupees.
Can I choose to not have a shield?
Not sure what it is, but look at that color. Yeah, for you, 500 rupees. This rare treasure is a pearl necklace. Does 50 rupees sound fair?
It seems like this would probably be a quest of some kind or some kind of like an ability. So I'm gonna buy this. You got a pearl necklace? This stunning pearl necklace grows elegantly in the light.
Thank you very much. Can I get you anything else?
No.
Thanks for stopping by.
Would.
Oh, gee.
No, hang on. Wait, I got it. Hang on. Wait, hang on.
Zoinks. Zoinks.
There it is.
Look at this remarkable ship. What do you think of it?
I'm kind of like Mr. Meeseeks.
Oh, look at it. Ah, what a ship. Such a proud beauty. It's time to lose all meaning when I gaze upon it. Oh, if she were only mine. It belongs to the sea captain Nichols by the name of Lionbeck. A fearless soul, I hear. He's seen the whole world, never seen defeat. What? You also searching for Lionbeck? That captain usually drives anchor at the milk bar, but I haven't seen him in days. That's the bar owner knows where Lionbeck has vanished to.
Okay. That's Lionbeck? What do you mean? That's not. What?
Shipyard, be right back.
Did you just spoil me that that's Lionbeck? Okay. Did I? I mean, he just told me that I have to go somewhere else to see Lionbeck and said that Lionbeck hasn't been seen for days. And then you said, that's Lionbeck.
No. I've been to a lot of places. But a milk bar here? Yes. Yeah. Yeah.
A new customer. Oh, I had the greetings. Lots of locals dipped in yet while away at the hour. But it's empty at the moment. But aren't you a bad sort to be in here? Take no offense, sir. You'll be more than welcome when you've got a little bit further in life. Looking for Lionbeck? Oh, I know him. That's the tailor there. Knew him recently. Lionbeck just dashed out, saying that he was off to see the Temple of the Ocean King. I tried to stop that crazy fella, but off he went to the north side of my isle.
My ears hear that, right? He went to the Temple of the Ocean King?
I've already forgot what voice I gave this man.
Listen up, young'un. Listen good. The Ocean King is defender of all creation, and that temple up on the hill was built in his honor. None more worthy. Sadly, the curse was laid on the place that took souls from all who entered. And none dare step into the Temple of the Ocean King. So put it out of your mind. Can't say where your friend's gone, but I'll tell you this. Stay out later.
Yes, they're clear. That's what we all do. But the odd visitor, now and then, can't resist it. Where is it, right here on your map.
Yeah, I mean, I don't need to mark that down.
You're not going there, are you?
Who is this, greaser Dracula that's possessed you? Excuse me, if I wanted to do... I also seen Tingle, yes. If I wanted to do Dracula, I would go like...
blah, blah, blah. I'm Dracula. Hey, oh.
You know, I'd go like that angle, you know? Like, excuse me, all right? You know?
Hey, blah.
You know, like that kind of angle, you know what I'm saying? He doesn't go blah, blah, blah. He does.
Hey, we ain't ghost ship, I don't mean to take you. We got your sails, but stay away from that ship,
Hey, any the fortune teller, Astrid?
No.
I believe Astrid lives on the, Isle of Ember. Ghost ship, she saw it all in advance, she said. I bet she'd know what it, take for me to find a girlfriend. Yeah,
hi Ace, how are you? Spoiled that I'm gonna go out on the ocean just then, he did. Treasure teller opening soon. Treasure teller. 4K let you see what the actual paintings look like. It's too much effort for me to swap back and forth now. Two clicks. Fine, I'll do it. Fine. Probably not, though. Hang on. No. Because it's not actually recreating the textures or anything, it's just up-resing the pixels and then, combining them with interlacing. Okay. I'm well, how are you? I'm good. I'm doing swell, I'm doing dandy. You look so hittable? They are very hittable. Stick to hit and choose, though. Maybe one of them will turn into a slime girl. We did the roll! And tiny circle. It's really hard to do when you're on a mouse and you can go off screen at any time. Need to understand that, like, I'm not doing this on a touchpad, so I have a edge of the screen, and if it goes off the edge of the screen, it no longer does that circle. Another rupee. You got a big green rupee. Oh, wow. I thought it was going to be a gag. Like, in the tree that he told me about, there was a, what was the button to go to quick? There it is. I thought it was going to be a gag of, like, he told me, like, hey, if you want a bigger treasure, go check out this tree. But that tree is also just a single rupee. So I need a bomb.
Okay.
Just a prediction for the boss that is inevitably at the end of this temple.
Oh! Looks blank! Looks like someone's skeleton. What's it doing here? Think this could be Linebeck. This is really starting to creep me out.
I foolishly entered this temple. In moments, it drained the life right out of me. So even if you clear a trap...
Nothing changed? What do you mean? There you go.
So even if you clear a trap, it resets once you leave. I should have made notes in my map. But are you still the same? What do you mean?
I don't believe you. I don't believe you.
But I couldn't make notes on the maps that have these icons. You can't write on this map.
Okay.
I entered the temple in search of the treasure, but monsters that could not be slain with a sword stalked the corridors.
Okay. So I can't kill monsters. Or some of the monsters. I just don't understand the rule. I just can't do it. God damn.
Hey! Wait!
Hey, wait! Did you hear something, Splunk?
Oh, it was...
Hey, wait!
Did you hear something, Splunk?
Hey!
Okay, I definitely heard something, didn't you? Someone over there!
You, kid, over here. Kid, I'm talking to you. You came at the right time. You're lucky you...
Oh, wait, what's like, hang on, let me get there.
You're lucky you found me. Lucky for me, but luckier for you. Now help me.
Oh, him? That's Linebeck.
Hey, are you listening? I said help!
What is he screaming about? Someone pleading to be saved. That sure is rude.
What did you say? Oh, it's that chatty fairy from the old man's place. Yeah, I got it. Listen, can you help me out? Just pay attention to what I have to say. I know you're a kid and all, but try to listen up.
I feel like most people would have went like with a Johnny Depp kind of style of voice, so I wanted to go different.
I'm trapped in here, and I don't know what to do. Normally I'd free myself without any problem, but I sprained my ankle and I can't move. Will you help?
No way.
What? Wait! Can't you see that I'm begging? Come on, please!
Nope.
Kid, you're just heartless. You've got nothing to lose. Come on, help me out.
No way.
Kid, you're just heartless. You got nothing to lose. Come on, help me out.
fine.
I knew you'd come through for me, kid. Well then. Do something about these pointy spikes. There's got to be a way to disarm the trap somewhere around here.
My mind pack, just right there. That's how, Spike.
Where's my voice going?
Oh, hey!
Oh,
wait a second. There's something I forgot to tell you. One thing you should know about this temple. It'll suck the life out of you.
What? Why did you tell us sooner? That's pretty important, you know.
Let me finish. Don't go running away yet. I know it's scary, but it's not like the temple will suck all the life out of you all the time. I'm not sure, but as long as you stand on areas like this, you'll be okay. Show me that map. See those purple spaces? They're probably safe zones. Were you listening? Did you get all that?
Yeah.
Keep it straight up, kid. Don't be shy about breaking pots. Now get out of it. Now get me out of here. Yeah, like that.
Easy peasy.
Are you kidding me? That little boy did it! Okay, I'm taking that as my cue to get out of here. Free falldom!
Good gag right there. That gag right there, that was good shit. That was good shit.
I think we can take a quick breather. Hey,
Hey! You said you sprained your ankle! You're walking just fine! You said you needed our help!
Ugh. I like you're the one who did the saving. Hey, kid. You're pretty brave for someone so... short.
I see why this game resonated with Kwasan so intensely.
I mean, not as brave as me, but not too shabby. So your name's Spoik, huh? That's a... weird name. Name's Linebeck. I'm a real... sea man. Impressive, huh? It was smooth sailing for me in the beginning, but then I got myself stuck in that trap. This place will suck the life out of you, if you let it. Blasted temple. What are you doing in a place like this anyways? And what do you want from me, kid?
We're going for a ghost ship.
You're looking for the ghost ship? You're trying to get your bits on the treasure?
Treasure? What are you talking about?
God.
Mike is trying to save his friend. He was abducted by the ghost ship. I came hoping you would know more about it.
Really? Boo-hoo, how sweet. I think I'm gonna cry. I'm just teasing, kid. That's what this is about. I'm on board. I'm here looking for info about the ghost ship, too. I was just one step away, but then I sprained my ankle, so... otherwise, I would have explored this cursed place.
Liar! I just saw you running like a rabbit!
No, you didn't. That was just an illusion. A clever trick. My ankle is still throbbing. The pain is... unbearable! Ooh! Ooh, the pain! Anyway, you want to know about the ghost ship, go on without me, kid. Go grab the clue about the ghost ship. It has to be in here somewhere. We need to find the ship. Got that?
You're faking it. You think you're just scared.
Not a chance. Normally I'd be leading the charge down there, but I know how much it means to Sploik. I'm letting him have the glory of saving his friend. So anyways, here, kid. Take this with you. I found this key around here. It might help.
This game's good. You got a small key. It'll open and lock the door. Have to lock the door to unlock it.
You know what you got to do, so get to it.
This game's good.
Oh, and, good luck in there, kid.
This game's good. I don't know why people hate this game so far. This game's good so far. Alright. One moment, please. So, firstly, my earbud died, but we're not gonna worry about that, at this time. Ignore this, VOD Watchers. You've seen nothing. I didn't switch over my stuff. Hang on. Wait for it. Wait for it. Hang on. Wait. Boom.
Throw a wrench! This design on the floor must mean something.
Alright, design on the door. Oh, I see. So that's timed? Oh. I see. Well, I'm dead. First death of the game. Let's go. Little gesture character for a game I might make. And also for my animation product. If you plan to actually make the game, I would highly recommend you consider doing Unreal Engine, because you'll learn a lot of skills in game development that will help you elsewhere. Because everyone is using Unreal right now. Every single person is using Unreal. Unreal is so popular right now. It is actually kind of crazy how many studios are using Unreal. It is kind of unreal how many studios are using Unreal. Where did Stolen Croissant go? The bathroom. We were on a pee break. How is Unreal with 2D? What the fuck? We're in the fucking... What the fuck kind of fucking One Piece looking ass be? Okay, he found a sea chart. It must be an important clue to finding the ghost ship. You should show it to Linebeck. You can do both.
Oh, look at that old sea chart. I wonder if that's a clue to the ghost ship Linebeck was talking about.
But, like, the other, like, big option would be Unity, but Unreal is a bigger deal. So by using Unreal, you'd be able to learn skills that would transfer to a bigger studio if you planned to continue down the game development path. You could learn skills that could lead to you getting a job at a game studio, you know what I mean? And then also, like, let's say this goes a different way, right? Let's say instead, this game that you make is so successful that you're able to make this your own studio, right? Let's say that happens. Hiring people, way easier, because everybody knows Unreal right now. So it's like, it's, you could, Unreal is like the industry standard right now, so it's the thing that is most easily transferred around.
Hey, where's Lineback? Can you believe the nerve of that guy? Making us go in here by ourselves. Now that we got to say chart, I got some words for him.
What's a piece of that pirate ass? I said none of this. However, I think the voice I gave him is very good. For the character. I'm lying. I just said I only said that I didn't say that. I didn't say that you were wrong. I just said I didn't say that.
Isn't the little monkey and his twinkly pal. Slow getting the goods, huh?
Slow? How dare you! You're quick enough to run off, injury and all!
What an insult! I was merely hurrying back to my ship! Any captain worth his salt puts his ship before his own safety, I tell you. But tell me, little monkey, what did you find in the treasure chest? Ugh, a map! Let me look at it! What's this? It's a boring old sea map! Now I see. It is, as we call it in the adventuring business, a treasure map! Oh, if we probe its mysteries, we can find the very prize I'm seeking. A ghost ship. And by we, I mean me. Farewell, little monkey, I'm off to find adventure!
I'm just saying, I feel like I nailed this voice, okay? I think this is what he was meant to sound like. All right? I think this is what they envisioned. When Miyamoto drew the concept art for Lineback, because he certainly did, he was like, this guy sounds like a fucking nerd.
Well, look who's gracing our presence. It's old man Oshus.
Hey, Bertie's been fixed. I thought I'd take you up on a youngster here. You're an amazing lad to emerge alive from a temple spot. Very courageous for one so early in his years.
You sent me into that temple, that treacherous temple too, you old barnacle.
If you enter the temple unprepared, will find a terrifying ordeal. And most will lose heart and flee for their lives upon hearing me say it. Evidently, there are true heroes among us.
Breathe my feathers a little more, old man. I'm famous, all right.
Now, you fool, you're a wreck! You'd be sunk by now if our young friend here hadn't shown up.
I was injured! On a typical day, I'd blaze through one or two of these such temples for breakfast!
Calm yourself, Lineback, and tell me what you've made of the temple's map.
I've inspected it fully. My trained eye finds that it holds no secrets at all. But wait, old man. Do you know of this map?
Has the map special alluded you, Lineback? If I may see the map. A standard map would simply show you where to go, would it not? This has no standard map.
You'll find that one section is a little flaky. I trust you can solve the puzzle, Splunk.
What? Oh, it's a scratch and sniff. I wonder what it smells like.
Ass. That marks the worst spot of the island border of volcanic strife. It is the island of Ember.
Oh, I guess I can refund the prediction. It wasn't the boss.
Your fortune teller named Astrid lives there, and she sees far, Sploik. You should ask Astrid if she can see where the ghost ship might be. Isle of Ember, eh? I always suspected there might be something there. So it is as simple as sailing there and finding Astrid. So we're off to Isle of Ember then.
Hey, I'd like you to go, Sploik. You'll be essential to his efforts, I'm sure. Mostly because you mark where he's pointing. And by seeing him out of the outside world, you might just find your lost memory.
Got to! Happy to help! It's clear that we have to, go around with Lineback, though. Still, I'm glad to see all the seas. It's your world!
What? Don't tell me that I had to haul around that twinkly bit of fluff, too. Fine, then. Okay, Isle of Ember awaits. Ready to set sail? Let's go. We live bait with only that sword. Surely you should have a shield before we go.
No, I'm good.
We climb on board the open sea calls. It's off to the open sea with us then. I'll leave all the navigation to you while I stay down in the engine room. Tap the feather pen icon to access your navigation chart. Just draw a line and the ship will follow that exact path. Try it out.
Okay. Fuel shot? Yeah. Oh, can I change the camera? Oh, there we go. Oh.
Oh, almost forgot. See the engine on the right? Tap stop to, stop. And to resume, tap go. Well, I see if you want to touch it to look around the sea, touch the screen's edge. Be alert up there. Switch up and down, left and right, and you know, all the way.
Aboard the ship, yeah.
To beat a shop ship. I deal in everything and everything. What are you looking for? Huh? I must know. Just tap your selection.
Hey, oh.
Golden Amber. Ooh, Iron Navy Rupees. This price is crazy. Good thing. 500 rupees. What these and something good is bound to happen. Stock.
Okay. What's this?
Ship art. Strange chimney. 600 rupees. Now's the time to buy. Please come again. Thank you.
Nothing for me yet. Ship customization, yeah. Are they gonna lift me up? Belongs in the timeline. Canon event.
Okay.
Hey, we gotta go to the Isle of Ember. Set sail? What? Well, once you're done making waste, how about we make some haste? Come on.
Hey, nice to meet ya. Not like I, don't wanna greet ya, but I'm here to deliver your mail. Not talk your ear off. Yep, the postman lives for special delivery. And your name is... Got it, right here. Isn't it Splunk? I'm sure I'll be carrying special deliveries for you at some point.
So... This is in the Wind Waker timeline. But this isn't a Rito. At least not what the Rito looks like.
So, I'd appreciate it if you didn't, you know, shoot me the sling slot. Thanks for understanding. I may need to sign for deliveries. Thanks. On that note, see you around. Let's see, sir.
This doesn't look like a Rito.
Welcome to the ship junkyard at Edo's Garage. It's all Master Edo's. I know that Master wants to sell the cannon that he's working on. Come on back later if you're interested in getting your hands on one.
Okay, so this is a later thing. Yeah, so I can't really go anywhere yet. Okay, that makes sense. I like that I don't even need to swap the screens. It kind of just does it for me. All aboard! The roundabout for fun. Yeah.
Workouts. Wee! Woohoo!
I just took the most complicated route through the rocks. Wow, spoilers. I didn't know there were rocks in this game. Redeems are paused? Oh. Heard my name cause? Nope. I'll go for a burrito, though.
This must be the Isle of Ember that Grandpa was talking about. We're here!
Sterling example of my housemanship. Impressed, Sploink?
What? I didn't even know where the island was! Who sketched our course on the sea chart? Sploink did!
What? You piece of fluff. You don't appreciate the finer points of sailing. But you get me right, Sploink?
Yeah, do we get him? Yeah, do we understand him? No? No? No.
Your captain, will you? Look at you, little adventuring monkey. Why don't you run off and find Astro? I'll be right here waiting for you, taking care of my ship.
What? Stay behind? You're scared, aren't you?
Be scared? I'm never scared, you little fluttering shrimp. You two go ahead. I'll be breaking my back working on the ship for your sakes.
No one's here.
Isle of Ember. Thanks. My Beck is such a big baby, me too. Nobody's here. If you're reading my words, it means that I have fallen to fate. So look east to pick up the torch and take up my duty, K.O. K.O. K.O.
Wait, what happened on this aisle, Splink?
K.O. Come at me. K.O. I need to change that. Mr. K.O. Man, K.O. me banana. Daylight come at me, wanna go home. Hang on. 6, 12, hour, command, and shit. Third path, approval needed for entry. These are what's-its. These are the what's-its from the other games.
Rude.
Hang on, I'm thinking.
Rude force will get you nowhere. Wait, give me some warning before you come at me. I must look really bad, but I swear I'm not a bad ghost.
Well, to be honest, it doesn't really look evil.
My name is K.O. I used to work for Astrid the Fortune Teller. If you believe in fate, then it's not so bad. I do feel much lighter. A graver concern, though, is what's happened to Astrid. It haunts me.
Astrid? I came to this island to find her. You know where she is?
I hid her away. Astrid is inside her home right here. But there's no way I can open the door. Not in this condition. Would you please open the door?
Yeah, sure.
Of course! Open that door and let Astrid out!
I'd really appreciate if you could do this. Here's the secret to opening the door. The three torches on this island are the key to understanding. Keep that in mind and you may be able to open the door. One torch is right here. Please take care of Astrid.
Okay. How fucking dare you? Honestly? So fucking rude. Open the door or I'm gonna bust. Ooh, I like that it glitched up the map. That's really cool. It was a mystery with the torches. When we were playing on hero mode in that one game. I remember. Approval needed. Man, this song definitely hasn't gotten grading at all. Pussies. I gotta go learn more pixel art. Have fun. Not too much fun.
Hang on, Splunk. I found presents on the other side of this door. Yeah, I hear footsteps behind there. This door looks pretty locked. What should we do? Hey, let's call out. Ready? Okay, call out something now, loud and clear.
Oh, that's not how I did it. Hang on, wait. This button? No, that's pause. All right, hang on. Hang on, I know I bound this. Hang on, I know I bound this. What did I bind it to? I didn't think I'd have to use it ever. Button 10. What does that mean? I'll just use V. Okay, it might not be working. Hang on. Wait. Where's microphone settings? Audio settings, probably. External microphone.
Who's there?
What are you, Spike? You did it!
Are the monsters gone? Get me out of here!
It's, safe out here! Now asked us to open the door! So, are you the, fortune teller Astrid?
Indeed, I am Astrid. Yes, but, favor to KO. Look at the map hanging beside the door. Simply touch it. I don't know who you are, but could you open this?
Yeah, sure.
Thank you, and good luck. This will be tricky.
I hope she looks horrendous. Mark the location of the map with three torches. Well, there's one. Oh, okay. There's one there. There's one there. I'm gonna take a guess. I'm gonna say it's right here. Hey. I know. Alright, I'm gonna take a guess. Okay. I'm gonna take a guess. Okay, alright. I'm gonna take a guess. Okay, I'll go fucking look. Alright, I'll go look around. Alright, I'll go look around. You want a hint? No, go look around. Heard one of me, goddamn. God dang.
To open the seventh gate, you need what the fortune teller has to offer. Whether you believe in her fortunes, however, is up to you.
How are we feeling about the banana? Yeah, do you guys like my banana? Damn it, I was hoping that would cause a jump. Are there other options? There are. I just thought the banana would be funny. I could have made it a master sword. I chose to make it a banana. Yeah, Ciela really wants the banana. When you got a carrot on a stick for like a pig, you know? Noise. I'm so significantly disappointed.
Thank you for opening the door. I'm finally free to go outside again. You bested the monsters who guarded me, so you are no ordinary traveler. May I ask you your names?
No.
Well, don't be modest. This is Spoink, and I'm Ciela.
Is it Ciela? I think it's Ciela, not Ciela. This is an E. I think it's Ciela.
Nice to meet you.
Spoink. Invoke sadness and strength in the same breath.
Lovely name.
Now, tell me, what brought you to our island? You can't ever forget your purpose for coming to our island. Hasn't something important brought you here? You're forgetful. You might want to add more muscle to your mind. I remember, why did you come to our island?
It was a ship. That's right.
Spoink is looking for his friend. He was taken by the ghost ship. Astrid, we were hoping that you might have some insights.
That's so. The ghost ship came to our island a few days ago.
My autism answered a ship. Not because the ghost ship, but because that's what we rode on. What?
That's why I was hidden away, to escape its ruinous reach. Speaking of which, I haven't seen Chaos since then.
Astrid, about that, well, Chaos, he's.
I see. I sensed it. Just as I foresaw, but it was destiny. Well, life has little use for mourning, so Chaos thought. Shall I tell your fortune?
Nah.
It must be something very trivial. You don't have to restrain yourself.
I guess.
Please wait for me upstairs. If any others are waiting with you, please bring them along. with you to my chambers. Assemble yourselves and I will join you after. I make preparations.
Confound it. You'd think that someone who seeks the future would be on time.
Where is Astrid? Let's get our futures told and be done with it. Greetings. Now, if everyone is here, we can begin. Open my eyes to the future, a sinister darkness, the mighty sea, and the voice of sacred light. I see it. I shall speak. Listen with your hearts. You really want to find the ghost ship? You must be ready to clash with the very darkness itself. Knowing that, you still want to rescue Tetras?
Yeah.
Oh, I hit the wrong one.
Oh, very nice. The honesty in your eyes is crystal clear. Now make the haste to the Temple of Fire on the summit of this island.
Oh no, I haven't tried it on yet. How is it? When you try it on?
That must be
it. How's the print on the back? How's it look? Is it too high? Should I lower it for the future prints? What's up?
Give me deets.
Now you must defeat the power of the darkness that haunts the place. You will then find what you need to open the path that lies ahead of you. You have it with you to alter our doomed course of events, Bloin. But with the light that seeks your help, it's growing faint. Please hurry.
Power of darkness. Hey, kid. I just remembered I gotta go, polish the ship's, rudder.
Later, kid. Chase, what's with Lineback? Oh, let's just let him be. Hurry to the temple.
Is this the temple? Or am I going back to the sea? Go talk to Kao again. I like it. Good.
You have freed Astrid. For that, I thank you. Please continue to look after her for me.
Women can't look after themselves. You know how it is. Got it. I'll get it. I just want a heart so I stop hearing the bleep bloop. Damn it. Now, what's your favorite color of chew? Bleep bloop gives you power? I'd rather be powerless. Volcano, the fuck are you erupting? Watch out for falling rocks! Okay, they only mostly killed me. Ah!
he had a red ruple. Pull out the flames to illuminate the path ahead. I like where it is, but I think for the future, not as high. Picture, please.
Hang on, wait, I gotta go. It didn't work. Hang on, wait, I gotta go. It's not working. Alright, cool, I don't know how to do this. Can someone shout out Keon, please? Welcome, everybody, to this game. Where I have to go see what input I need to do to blow. I need to learn how to blow. I don't know how to blow. How do I blow? It seems like I was doing it right. If that's a microphone, like maybe... So, like, I see here in audio settings, it says blow noise and external microphone, right? Maybe I just dead-ass gotta go, like, ah! Okay. Ah! Ah! Got it. All right, we're good. That's good shit right there. That's good shit. Easy peasy. Answer the raid message? What was the raid message? I didn't read the raid message, I just read the raid. Why are you in retro? Oh, because I went over to Keon's stream and was like, hey, why do you always go in the retro category instead of the category in which the game you're playing is? And Keon gave me a full hawk of bullshit. And I was like, okay, I'll try. Here we are. I was like, okay, I'll try it.
It's got to face the power of darkness.
I went, hey, what's Drew playing? I like that. I like that it worked exactly like you said it would. Drew clip art?
Oh no! There are flames everywhere! Better not touch them!
Well, I maybe won't touch them after I go look at clip art. I kinda like it being up high. You think it should be lower? I like it up high, because when you have the hood down, I'm looking at, I guess I could show you. I mean, like, it might look weird. Yeah, there you go. I like it up high, because when you have the hood down, people will be like, oh, what's on your hoodie? And then you'd have to, like, lift it up and it'll become a conversation piece. You know what I'm saying? I don't know. That's good shit, you know? That's good shit. That's marketing right there. That's good. Looks good. Also, you look good. Good job putting that in art. Not because of the art that is on the back of the hoodie, but because you yourself are art. You yourself is a work of art. Okay? So, good job putting that in clip arts. Anyways. I already read that. But yeah, welcome everybody to Phantom Hourglass for everybody that came in that raid. We've been doing a Zelda-thon where we're playing through every single Zelda game ever made. Not just the canon ones. Every single one. We're up to Phantom Hourglass. This is a game that I have never played until now. And it is a game that is so far almost exclusively just the touch screen. So as you can see, we're controlling the game using a banana.
I'm going, burn your yourself, Splunk.
Oh shit, I burned myself. There you go. Oh shit. You hit the down button on the D-pad, it brings up the map. Yeah. Do memos? Yeah. Yeah, I knew that. Yeah, I knew that. Don't make haste, make note of the safe path. Okay. Oh, it's... Oh, wait, no, it's not that. It goes down sooner. It goes like this. Yeah, there you go. I'm an artist. I'm a fucking artist. Look at that. God damn. God damn. I did. Oh no! Bats! Not the hit film Morbius starring Jared Leto and Matt Smith! Oh no! Good night, Tamus. I love you. Mwah! Also, yes. Remy is so bad. Noise.
Rook E5 to G4, this is a clip art representation of a worm.
Check. Don't want to talk about it. I was curious. I then talked about it. Seems like I didn't need to make note. It just kind of is happening. Like I didn't need the note. Like I could very clearly see where it falls. Get punked? Yeah, kinda. I mean, like, why did they make me make a note? I didn't need to do that at all. The baby game for babies? Yeah, this is a baby game for babies. Clearly. It is what it is. Every now and then, I see a rat. I remember one from Ratatouille. My heart wants. Is this like a different kind of chew? My baby brain thought Tetra was cute. She is. Not like that, but she is. Boomy.
Boomerang! How to throw it?
I so know how to throw it. I know how to throw it so well. Check this out. That. Threw that so well. I could also do that. See that? I know how to throw this. Look at that. I'm throwing it so good. Look at that. See that? That Look at that. Through so. Oh. Hang on. Let me try again. Shit. Hang on. Let me try again. There you go. Yeah. I drew Squidward. It's a fat bean, or no, it wasn't. What are you talking about? I didn't draw. What? Don't make it perverted. I didn't draw a peanor. I don't know what you're talking about. Move while the boomerang is going? Yes. Okay. How far does the boomerang go? Not. Wait, can I go? Can I? Hang on. Wait. Let me test something. Ah! It didn't work. Okay. So if it puts out those flames, can it put out the flames here? Or is there another one of those pot things? Yeah, it is. Okay. Those orbs. Killing it torches will not make them go away. I learned that. You want a mechanic tip? Nope. There are no treasure chests on this floor. Okay. I hit the wall. It didn't. In fact, it went through a wall. Yeah, hang on. Let me try something. That's a map. X is also map. Ah! Okay. Finally, my left hand can do something other than rub my nuts.
Drew, DRBW would say that French here.
Oh, yeah? Very good cheer. We can't hear the SFX. There was no SFX. The game crashed. So, there's an autosave, right? Okay. Hang on. Welcome back, VOD Watchers. I replayed it. I got back to the point where we were. It took 45 minutes, but we got back to it. Welcome back. Welcome back. Okay. Now I can't spend my hard-earned American channel points. You said 200 points, so I assume you're trying to do VIP. Dude redeemed VIP yesterday, so it's on a 7-day cooldown, so you would be able to do it in 7 days. I realize that my camera is not centered. There you go. I think that's centered. So yeah. That is why. Now we're playing again, and everything is new. And I need to save the game more, okay? We learned our lesson, need to save more. Oiled again by dude? I know, right? Oh, I see. Hey, Genesis, how you doing? There are no treasure chests on this floor. Okay. Rude. Chilling out tonight. How are you? I'm doing swell. This is where it crashed. Boy. Is that a choo-choo? Yeah. Well, that was a fucking skull thing, but things before were choos, yeah. I didn't think it hit me. You can tell this is a sequel to Wind Waker by the tunes, the very repetitive tunes, yes. Number of treasure chests left here is 1. Oh, no thanks. Interesting, it costs rupees to see where the treasure chests are now. That's interesting. I need to stop relying on the, Oh, I can't hit them. Interesting. Those enemies can't be hit. The repetitive tunes are one of the many reasons people don't like this game. Okay. Well, I agree with that one. But it's not a deal breaker. But it's not a deal breaker. I'm sure they didn't like the touchscreen controls either. I don't have a key. Let's just assume there's a lot of reasons. The little bell sound. I like the little bell sound it made. So far, the highlight of this game has been the animation, honestly. I really like this boomerang mechanic, though. This is really cool. This is a cool way to use this item. Is it infinite? Oh, hi. No. One, two, four, three. One of my friends told me the only Zelda game she had even 100%ed was Skyward Sword, and I almost died till she followed up with it was because she and her friend were partaking in some totally legal hallucinogens at the time. Skyward Sword is a good game. It has bad parts. The first, and by far biggest, is the sky stuff. Anytime you're flying on that bird, bad. All of that, bad. It shouldn't be. That is the selling point of the game. That part's bad. The motion controls. They could be way better. They could be. Are they bad? No. They could be way better. However, every single one of the flaws, a lot of people don't like the art style. Every single one of the flaws with this game that you could list are immediately made up with, by far, and it's not even close, by far, the best soundtrack of any Zelda game, and the best storyline of any Zelda game, including Twilight Princess. That game is really fucking good. Twilight Princess is better overall, but it's really fucking good. That is all. That is all. She had been playing Zelda since the 90s. Like, you start 100% with the ones in the 2010s. I mean, it's a good game to 100%. Only 100% in Minish Cap. I've 100%ed. Skyward Sword, No, I didn't 100% Four Swords. I did Skyward Sword, Minish Cap, Ocarina of Time, Majora's Mask, Twilight Princess, in my heart, I 100%ed Wind Waker, but I honestly didn't. What else have I 100%ed out of the series? I think that might be it. I 100%ed six out of the games. Wait, that can't be right. I feel like I've done more. I can't alt-tab. Hang on, I'll save. Honestly, Quack, with what I now know is the 100% goal, I would say you 110%ed Wind Waker. I think I 100%ed it. I think you 110%ed it. You know what I mean? maybe even more. Maybe you 200%ed it, honestly, with what you have to do to 100% that game. I think you 200%ed that game. Is that right? Did I get all the ones that I've 100%ed? I didn't 100% Hyrule Warriors. I have done... I think I did all shrines in Breath of the Wild. I did get the tunics. So I've done all shrines in Breath of the Wild, but I didn't do the Koroks. I've 100% of Link's Awakening. That's the one I was forgetting. So I've 100% of Skyward Sword, Minish Cap, Ocarina of Time, Majora's Mask, Twilight Princess, Wind Waker, I'm gonna take it. Link's Awakening. So we're 11 games in right now. I know that says 9, ignore it. We're 11 games in right now. And I've 100%ed 7 out of them. We haven't done Link's Awakening yet, so we can take that off the board. So 6 of them. So we've done 11 games, and I've 100%ed 6 of them. Yeah. Did you do Triforce Heroes? Triforce Heroes is not done yet. Triforce Heroes is in the other timeline that we're not doing right now. Well, we will. Think of a Zelda game? The answer is yes, we're playing it. Unless I'm physically unable to do, because I couldn't play Tetris Tracker. That is a game that I physically can't play. Because you not only need a GameCube, which I could do, you also need a Game Boy Advance. Not one, but multiple in order to play it. So I can't do that game. That's not happening. Maybe one day. Are you playing the Zelda visual novel? I did read the Four Swords visual novel about a third of the way through. But I'm good. Playing the non-official one. I'm playing all the CDI ones. I'm playing... if I can get I don't know if it exists on emulator, because I can't get the physical one. It's super rare and doesn't exist anymore. The Game & Watch Zelda game, there's one of those. I'd like to do that. There's a Ancient Stone Tablets. I'm going to be playing that. There's a bunch of them. We're going to be watching the animated series. There's a bunch of them that just click on the timeline link. Just type exclamation mark timeline and click on the link. You can see every game that we've completed and or are going to. The only two that it isn't updated with is Wind Waker and the first Tingle game, because we've done those. So. Are you doing the remake for the CDI games? I heard someone made a version that is actually playable. We might not do the remake of the CDI versions. I don't know. We're not there yet. I'm not thinking about it until we get there. Hi, Chai. How are you? I would like to play the new game that they just put out. The developers of the CDI games put out a new game in the CDI style, but is actually a game, like it's its own game. I would like to play that after we play the CDI games, just to see how far they've come. When do you get a floppy green hat? When you buy it for me. Four, what do you want? Okay. Jesus Christ. Can't count it. Yeah. I do a little twirl. Twirl, honey, twirl. And twirl, honey, twirl. I literally have it marked on my map. I forgot. Sorry, we had like a whole conversation in between then. I can't tell which one of the... Oh, wait, no, I know which one's two. This one. And this one. And this one. And this one. There we go. Oh, sorry. let go too soon. There we go. Okay. Do you think Helldivers is worth it? I'm on the fence at the moment. I've played Helldivers for... We'll get there, give time. We'll get there. Give time, hang on, I'll get there. Dave, sure. Twenty-five hours almost. And there has not been a single hour that I have not enjoyed. I fucking love this game. I want to play more of this game. Because I fucking love this game. What about a single minute? There has been a single minute that I did not enjoy. I highly recommend you play it with friends, though. It is much more fun with friends. It's still fun alone, though. That game is very secretly a comedy. It hides it well, but it is a comedy. I will never get sick of, like, I'll never get sick of, like, fucking, where's, like, a gun? Oh, here we go. I'll be like, we'll be fucking... It'll be like me and a teammate, and we'll be like sitting on a rock, like shooting down at Terminids and the bugs, shooting down at them, and it'll be like real intense, and then it'll like calm down. We'll have like a calm moment, and we'll like stand there waiting for like the extraction to come, and I'll just turn to him and go, "Huh!" And just like fucking punch him off the cliff, and he just fucking ragdolls off the cliff. Funniest shit in the world. Does not ever stop being funny. It is always funny. Or, like, we'll be sitting there, and there'll be that calm moment. The same exact calm moment. The exact same situation leading up. And I'll, like, look at him, and I'll go, "Huah!" And I'll just fucking launch myself off the cliff, and I'll ragdoll. Like, funniest fucking shit. That game is, like, so very hidden secretly a comedy. You know? Like, it makes you think that it's this super intense action game where you're taking down these hordes of bugs or robots, but it's not. It is 100% a comedy. All the way down to you're fucking hunting, you're killing these bugs and shit, and you call in like a reinforcements because your teammate died, and your teammate fucking zooms down and lands right on top of you. Fucking hilarious every time. Every time. Like, that game is a very secretly a comedy. It hides it super well. But that is a comedy game. And just generally a good time. Damn it. There we go. Oh, fuck. Man! There, Jesus Christ. Because if I let go of LT or LB before I finish doing it, it just doesn't do it. Yeah, and I got a heart out of it. Let's go, baby! Shit, I lost the heart. Okay. I realize I opened a shortcut and didn't have to redo all that, I don't think. The more you know. Go get him. Got one of them. Somehow Link turns into Mr. Krabs when he's shocked. How you doing, Chompers? How's how you doing, Beals? I don't know if I ever said. My bad. I love how the fucking bottom screen, or I guess top screen, how the top screen gets all janky. Whenever he gets shocked. I think that's really fucking, that's a really cool little detail. They didn't have to do. Like, it doesn't really, like, functionally, it doesn't really do much. Like, it doesn't affect me. You know, it's just a cool little detail. That I hope, is carried over to Spirit Tracks when you get there. I hope that they keep that, because that's really cool. Same story with, Link Between Worlds and, in those when we get there. I hope that that trend keeps up. Where they, where every time I get shocked, it fucks up the other screen. I appreciate that, Chompers. Good night, I love you. Mwah! Ah! Ah! I don't know if I would suggest it. You have a good night's rest. Ah! Is it randomized? Oh no, it did it. It did it. It did it. Okay. It did it. It was a permanent thing. Got it. I already got it. Yeah. I realized that now. And then I died in here. Oh yeah, by the way, I didn't mention, for VOD watchers, when we had to redo all that content, the only thing that we missed, obviously we don't have the same amount of rupees. That's not something that I can control. But we didn't buy the pearl necklace this time, and I tried to go back to buy it. And it wasn't there. Thank you. just catch this flaming boomerang? Oh. Okay.
Peace and love, bro.
I'm pretty sure still running. There was never one. Okay, well now there is. Get on, get in on the prediction fast, or you're gonna miss your chance. Because once I get to that boss room, I'm gonna disable it so that you can't redeem anymore, or rather predict anymore. Which is gonna be in like 2 seconds. So like, get in on it quick. Get in. Predict fast. If there's an empty spot that nobody's predicted it in, that happens to be the time that I win, the points go into the void. So even if you just put in one clinky, make sure you put in points on all of them. That's cool. Step into the blue light to return to the temple's entrance. No. This temple is protected, protects the spirit of power. Okay. Alright. Last chance to enter the prediction. In 5. Now I'll do 10. In 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Locked. Okay. Hi, Dumpling. How are you? Little gremlins?
I ain't buying.
Interesting. Okay, I think I figured it out. There's an order to it. I don't know, it's working out. know this song. I think it is. No.
I am Leaf, spirit of power. I serve the Ocean King. I owe you a thanks for defeating that evil wizard. You broke the seal, so now I'm free.
Look, Spork! It's the spirit of power, Leaf! This must be what Astro was talking about.
Please help us. We need your strength. I was locked away with the Ocean King years ago, but now I can't feel the Ocean King's presence. I wonder what happened to him. If I come with you, maybe I can find out. If you need it, I'll gladly lend a hand.
Like a thick fairy to me.
Heavy's dead as hell.
First try. Are you Drew in chat? I've been having a bad day. But I'm still good. The volcano has stopped
erupting, Spork. I bet it's because you defeated all those monsters. Come on, let's tell Astrid.
Yo, Astrid.
Kid, so were you able to defeat all the monsters? Well, Astrid is waiting.
Well done. You defeated the power of darkness, Bloink. Thus, you've broken the seal that imprisoned the spirit. You need to move ahead. Ultimately, you'll need three spirits: power, wisdom, and courage. When you have all three, you will possess the power to find the ghost ship. Now two spirits remain. The locations are veiled to me at the present. I see another clue for you to find in the Temple of the Ocean King on Mirkay. And to further your efforts, I give you this. May it help you in battle.
Nice.
That's a spirit gem. There are many for each spirit. Find as many as you can. I see that somewhere on the seas, you can raise a spirit's powers for 10 gems. The light that seeks your aid grows weaker still. There's no time to lose.
You actually did it! Now we're even closer to getting rich, Bloink. Wow, I'm excited.
Oh, so centered!
Well, I sense that man will prove to be an asset, not an anchor, in time.
Rob, you're right! Let's quickly set sail back to Mirkay Islands, Blink!
Okay!
Whoops, I pressed the wrong button.
What's it taking so long? I was about to leave you here, Spelunk.
What? Back? What are you calling out about?
I suspect that we're hot on the trail of untold wealth. Don't you suspect that the light that needs finding is really a shiny treasure?
I really don't think so.
Anyway, let's head back to Mirkay Island.
Okay.
I haven't forgotten anything, have you? Let's be off.
You taking any medicine, Beale? Head back to Murkay Island, so I assume, a little hook shot. Yeah, I feel as though I'm leaving this part in. What do I do about that? I assume I gotta shoot it or something, but I don't have a cannon. Oh, I can jump. I didn't know that. I'm leaving this part in for this VOD, but in future VODs, I'll probably cut this out unless something interesting happens. Dave, can I save while I'm on the boat? Yes, I can. Oh. Here's the pearl necklace.
Member's card just for you. The more you buy, the more points you'll earn, and the happier you'll be. I pamper my customers. No other shop offers such rewards, you know. And that brings your point total to 1. Try to earn 20 points and earn a silver membership.
Okay.
Thank you.
I need a cannon before I get any, like, I need offense before I get defense, you know what I'm saying? Use my pearls. Pearls is code for my salty balls. How do I unread something? Zora scale. I was hoping you'd have a cannon. This wasn't open before. Maybe this is like a. Maybe they got ship parts.
Come on in. You found yourself in the shipyard. Want to customize your ship? You got the parts, I've got the time.
Ooh. Interesting. Average Proud came with equipped on the SS Lineback. He named his ship after himself. Very interesting. Handrail, bridge, chimney, wheel. And I imagine this will probably be cannon. Tap the ship to touch on the touchscreen to change the viewing angle. Got a ship wheel. Oh. Right now we have the normal wheel. This is the shell wheel. Rare, actually rare? Well, I'm a gamer, so. Created from the shell of a huge snail, a mysterious design. What can I say? I'm a gamer. Not the rarest? Yeah, but I'm a gamer, so... You know. This is good enough for me. I noticed... Oh, there we go. Because it was loading. My banana goes away when loading. And now our ship's got a big-ass shell. CSGO case opening boat parts. Mm-hmm. This is Merkay Island, right? Did you read what he said? Maybe. I don't know who he is. But also, I did read it the first time. Changed about the ship's stats. Oh, no, I didn't read that.
Hey, wait. If you push yourself that hard from the beginning, you won't last. I understand wanting to hurry, but don't waste your energy. Don't forget that this cursed temple can suck the life out of you. I know we have to search for clues to find the spirits, but we need some kind of strategy. Just don't end up like this. Hey, you know, I mean, if you say you want to go it alone, then who am I to stomp you, but,
What? You're trying to put all the work on Sploik again? If you know it's dangerous, shouldn't you be helping too?
Well, yeah, kid, the temple is a little dangerous. Not a place for, kids. If you go in, well, might not make it very far. That's not exactly true. I'm impressed that you managed to free the spirit power. You are strong. Even if you follow the ghost ship, you will be fine. Sploink. Get up on that altar. Get on up of that altar. Get dinky, Benny. Get on up of that altar. Heh, but Danny.
Oh my god. Is it the You got your sand in my hourglass.
Now Sprunk, take the hourglass.
Okay. It's a mysterious hourglass filled with golden sand. You now hold the legendary phantom hourglass,
Link. Or Splink. Try for your name for a second there. This temple, as long as you carry it, this temple cannot drain the life from you. However, you are only safe as long as sand remains at the top of the phantom hourglass. When all the sand is drained to the bottom, your life too will be drained.
It's an hourglass. Can't you just flip it over again?
No. Once the sand of the hours is drained, its power is gone. It needs a light of the sun to restore its mystical power.
Huh, I get it. So, we have to go outside the temple again.
And inside this phantom hourglass is called the Sand of Hours. Beast you defeated in the Temple of Fire held some grains in it. said to be made of force gems of the great king.
Force gems? I, in no fucking universe, I never fucking expected force gems to come back. I never fucking expected that. That is fucking wild. Force gems, chat, force gems were a replacement for rupees. They replaced the so usually in every single one of these Zelda games, the monetary value is called rupees. Instead of money, it's rupees. However, in only Four Swords Adventures, which, by the way, is not part of this timeline. But specifically in only Four Swords Adventures, in only that game, Force Gems replaced the rupees and were the entire mechanic of the game. Everything revolved around Force Gems. The fact that it is coming back in this game is fucking crazy. But also makes a little sense because this was 2007? When did this game come out? Was this 2007 or 8? Was this 2007 or 8? Phantom, hang on, I'm gonna get it. Phantom Hourglass. 2007. This was 2007. I didn't know you were born in 2007. You're not allowed on Twitch. This was made in 2007. The previous game that came out on handhelds would have been Four Swords Adventures, I think. I don't think anything else has come out in between that. So the previous game to this one would have been Four Swords Adventures. So it kind of makes sense. But also, different timelines, was not expecting that to happen. Anyways. Now that I've had my nerd emoji moment, moving on. Notice that it doesn't look as sharp for you guys as it does me. I can fix that, but I need to get out of this cutscene first.
It gives deep strength to whoever holds its power. From now on, you must defeat monsters and collect their sand of hours. The more sand you place in the hourglass, the longer its power will last. Sea chart we found in this temple showed where to find the captured spirits. If that's the case, then the location of the other two spirits, well, I bet there's another clue hidden somewhere in this temple. I just know it. I won't stop you, Splink. Dive deeper into this mystery, but keep the Phantom Hourglass in hand.
Bro, Astrid was saying that the sacred light was fading? We gotta hurry!
How do you know so much, old man?
Actually, I would be allowed on Twitch. People born in 2007 are 17 now. That's not true. It's 2024. 10 years would be 2017. So they would have been 10 in 2017, 2018, 2019, 2020, 21, 2020. Oh my god, it's true. Oh my god, it's true. Oh my god, it's true. Oh my god. Okay. Anyways, I can't hyper-focus on this one for too long. I'm just gonna push on.
That long story is not yet ready to surface, but all come time. For now, you must find the ghost ship.
That's right. A positive treasure awaits, ready to leap into my pockets. Up to it, Sploink. Put some steam in your engines and let's get exploring this temple, kid.
Okay. We got 10 minutes.
Blink! Look at the upper.
Fucking, you're gonna fucking. I'm skipping this, alright? Fucking.
Not the sand!
It'll suck the life out of you. Remember to keep an eye on the time.
Alright, cool.
This is the door of power. Use my strength to open it. Tap the door, and let's go deeper into the temple.
I'm still going down when I'm standing in it? No, so it's only 10 minutes when I'm not in the thing. Hey, Whimsy, how you doing? Let's use the, Umi to scout ahead a little bit. That work? How you doing, Tri? So I need a bow for that, probably. That's how it worked in the other games. A dark nut this early in?
Hey, it's an enemy! You know what to do.
Wait, Splink. The evil that cursed this temple made these monsters. Phantoms are very dangerous enemies.
Oh, these aren't dark nuts. These are phantoms.
Their armor is nearly impenetrable, and they strike very hard.
Does that mean you can't defeat them? There has to be a way.
Well, all you can do is sneak by the phantoms so they don't see you. You can watch their movements on your map. This is where the phantoms are.
Oh my god.
So, we're gonna sneak around them like thieves, huh? What if we're seen?
They see you, and run straight for the safe zone.
My safe zone? Do you mean those purple spaces on the ground? Oh yeah! Sand stopped moving in the hourglass when we were in one.
That's right. Those purple tiles on the floor are safe zones. The temple's curse makes it a dangerous place, but it's not all bad. Safe zones, remain as places that evil can't get to.
Okay, so if a phantom spots you, just run to a safe zone. That's easy. Right, Splink?
I wish when I booted in these games, it asked me how old I was. So that it didn't treat me like I was 3 years old. Yes.
Lighting the torches should open the way. But how am I supposed to open two of them?
Or light two of them, rather. Okay, so I need fire. I'm scared and impressed by that falsetto voice. Have you never heard me do my toad voice? Because I'm the toad. Does that light it? I don't think this lights the... I haven't. Thing that he says in Mario Kart that we reference all the time. What is it? It's, yeah, what does he say in Mario Kart? What's the one? He used to say it all the time. No, he says something stupid. Yeah, he said, he goes,
Yaha, Puma!
That's what he goes. He goes,
Yaha, Puma! Yaha, Puma!
Sounds better if I back away because I'm peeking. But yeah, I'm the Toad voice actor. Nintendo might deny it. But it's what I am. It's the truth, and I know it in my pussy. Why did I do that? Just fucking hit it. Fucking... I need this phantom to be over here. Oh shit, I forgot I said I was gonna fucking make it higher quality for you. Hang on, let me save. How you doing, H2O? Also, it's not ha 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 boomer. I believe it's ya ha ha boomer. I believe it's that. But nitpicking. Okay, hang on. Let me make it a little bit better for y'all. So Mel, thank you for the raid, right as I'm fixing something. Good timing. Can someone shout out Mel, please? How you doing, Mel? Wrong copy-paste. But I need to know. Oh, shit, it opened on the monitor that I can't see.
What the? Stop it!
Okay. We need to hit this. Nailed it. First try. Oh, I got it anyways. You're so good? Fuck, I was aiming for bad. Huh. Oh, that made them turn. Interesting. This is Phantom Hourglass, everybody. This is our, I think this is our 12th. I haven't actually done the math. I probably should have before we started. Break a red pot to spill its magical contents on the floor. And in the puddle to conceal yourself. Interesting. This is, I believe, the 12th game in the timeline that we've played. Actually 13th total. Because we couldn't play one of them. One of them couldn't be played. I need to redo the math, because I think it's 35 games now, because we couldn't do Tetris. So we're pretty far into the Zelda timeline. However, you don't necessarily need to know the entirety of the Zelda's timeline to experience this game. In fact, you just straight up don't. I like knowing the timeline stuff because it's fun, but you don't need it to enjoy the game or watch the game. So, in this game so far, we are the characters from The Legend of Zelda Wind Waker, Princess Zelda has been taken by a spirit, I think, inside of a ghost ship, and we are on a mission, to find the ghost ship and rescue her from the ghost ship. We don't know what the purpose of her being taken is. We know that multiple other people have been taken. We just need to get her out. We are doing this by use of our fairy here that I forget the name of. And a seaman named, Linebeck. With their helps,
I have you now.
W-
with their help, we are finding the ghost ship. Ciela. Can I get in here? No, I need the key. Oh shit. That didn't work. How do I get past this? Remember the pots? Oh, did I walk by some? Oh yeah, you're right, I did. Playing fast and loose. So right now, you look at the bottom screen, or actually the top screen, but look at the screen that's below me. And you can see a timer in the top left. That is the titular Phantom Hourglass, ticking down time. While we're not standing in one of these safe zones, the timer is going down. I think I just realized what's happening. Seven push-ups. Range goes way further than their cone. Oh, so that reduced time. Way further than their cone. Oh, it can't go past that? Didn't know that. I like that the heart beeping sound is in rhythm with the music. I don't like that the heart beating sound exists. Up there, is that different elevation? Different elevation, okay. Someone need DoorDash. Someone needs to DoorDash me some booze. I need it after today. You okay? Man, you said pee randomly, and I know that it was just random, and I get it, but, like, in my brain, I was like, man, I missed Liza Penis. I think it was great. Thank you. So what I thought was going to happen is I thought they were going to step on this switch and it was going to work. I didn't have it. Oh. I once, yet again, another example of me playing a baby game created for babies and thinking like an adult. Yet another example of me thinking like an adult when I need to lower my IQ to the level of a 3-year-old. God damn it. There's so many examples at this point. God damn. Like, I'm actually too smart, and it's a flaw. The clue to the ghost ship rests on this,
floor. Just a little further.
Okay. Wow, I've never seen this symbol before. Oh, I see.
I have you now. I'll get you.
I'm getting... Oh, force gem.
You got a force gem. You got a...
Triangle.
What are you supposed to do with it?
That's a force gem. Stolen by the Ocean King by the hands of evil. You need the power of the force gem to open the door and delve deeper.
So what are you supposed to do with this force gem?
I can see it over there. There are the pedestals where the force gems go.
Hi Vic, how you doing?
Place all the force gems here and the door will open.
Oh, we just have to take, take these force gems there.
Be careful. Move a lot slower when you're carrying a big force gem.
It's like, it's one of those things where it's like, you don't need to say this. You know? Like, is this why children have mush brains nowadays? It's like, they get everything explained to them to the letter. You know? Because it's like, let the kid figure it out.
Don't be a hero. Drop the force gem and run to a safe zone.
Temple, right, Spike?
This is why I have mush brain. Well, I wasn't going to say it, but like, yeah. Why did I leave? Bad. Turning into a boomer? Turning into? Bitch, I've been booming. Yeah, somebody redeem the border chain, whatever it's called. Please do it. Coward. Y'all still haven't seen all this. Well, that's the one that hasn't really changed much. Hey, man, guy, how you doing? How you doing? How? Drew, I don't know if you know this, but your cursor is a banana. That's what's making our fairy chase it, is the banana. She really likes them. We
The game wouldn't function if we hadn't found a banana early on. Link's POV? When what? When Ciela goes in front of her face? Ciela? Ciela? Mosa? Chitty chitty? Bang bang? Need to break those on the spot. I can break those wherever I want. I keep doing that. Shit, I fucked up the murder. Murder! Ooh! Wonder what would have happened if he had the key still. Think it would have, like, coughed it out? See how close he was standing to the blinding light? I'm not really paying attention. Like, I'm not actually playing the video game, okay? I'm just kind of drifting. Oh, that blinding light. Yeah. After he puts the thing in, he gets, like, the little dots on his eyes. Yeah, I definitely don't recognize that symbol or anything, and don't know it to be something, else, Ooh, I got time! Step into the blue light to return to the temple's entrance. Oh. Didn't recognize that as a child? You said this was the first game that you played, so of course you didn't recognize it as a child, because you didn't play any games before this. I, on the other hand, have played all the games so far, so I know that symbol. Or, I mean, I don't know that symbol. This Navi voice actor is so realistic. Excuse me? This is Ciela? It's different.
So we got another seat chart, but it looks different from the last one. Right now we can explore new areas of the sea. Let's show Lineback.
Well, I was saying Ciela before, but then I noticed that when you typed it out that it's spelled with an E, not an A. So in turn, it wouldn't be Ciela, it would be Ciela. Or Ciela. Where are you going to get that? The only game I played and finished from this franchise is Four Sword Anniversary. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry that you haven't experienced a Zelda game. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry that that's the one. I'm so sorry. I'm legitimately so sorry. I'm so sorry. No, I loved it. I said what I said. I'm so sorry. But that's the one, the only one that you've experienced. And that you don't know the glory that is. I'm sorry that you've never experienced an orgasm in your life, but, like, it is what it is, you know? didn't get far into Majora's Mask. Majora's Mask. Majora's Mask might be the hardest Zelda game. Not as in, like, combat-wise, but just difficult to play. And yet, it's so worth the playtime. It's so worth 100%ing. It rewards you so well. Such a rewarding experience. But it's the hardest one to play. Okay. I've never played any Legend of Zelda, however, I'm very much educated in the content. I mean... I'm of the opinion, and it is an opinion, that majority of games... Watching a video game is the same as playing a video game, most of the time. Many people would disagree with that, and I wouldn't argue it. But that is my opinion all the same. I want to play Link's Awakening, because it's supposed to be similar to Four Sword and combat and puzzle stuff, right? I'm not going to say anything, just because I want you to play it.
Bombs, right?
That'll be 50 rupees. Can I buy them?
Oh, you don't have a bomb bag.
Okay, cool. I mean, I would like to be full health, but I don't need it, so I'm not gonna buy it. I need to save money for a, cannon. Suffice to say, Link best waifu? No.
Come on in, you found yourself at the shipyard. One customized ship, got parts, got time. Got many time, y'all. Customized ship, total free.
You said that I could see ship stats. How do I do that?
Good swapping out your parts. Stop by any time you want to change them. Your ship stamina will go up if you use parts from the same set. Spearmint.
Oh, okay. I thought you meant like different parts gave different stats. Got it. Didn't even know the ship had stamina.
Does that ship of yours have a cannon?
No. Wait, no, it was,
Zoinks! Zoinks!
They make sea life easier, or at the very least, louder.
Hang on, I got it, hang on.
Zoinks! They make sea life easier, or at the very least, louder. That's all I know. I heard you can get them from a guy named Edo on an island of the south.
Okay. You border again, coward. Give that voice to another guy? I thought it was that guy. Oh, I don't know why I'm not reading this.
Yeah, we found your set chart.
Let me see that. The chart we need to sail into the sea that's up north. But I still don't know the location of the ghost ship. Well, blow me down to the ground.
Oh, hang on. Ah! Ah! No? Ah! Dang it.
Make yourself useful and clean it up, will you, Sploike?
Don't cool down.
Oh.
Damn it, oh my god. Ah! Ooh! Damn it, fucking, oh my god. Okay.
Achoo! Hey, look, I mean, I knew it was all along. I knew it was sitting there. Yes,
Sailor, I need to compliment your work. Yesterday, you changed my title, and like maybe six, maybe more, people came into chat and questioned me about it. I need to compliment your work.
I've always had a sixth sense for such things.
Are we falling? We are falling for the line back. You didn't know it was there.
Don't pretend to know what I don't know. Anyway, I bet the spirit's right there. So let's go to that island.
That one.
Okay then, once we set sail, I'll explain how we can go to the northwestern sea.
Check this out, chat. Check this out.
Now you can see both at the same time. If you blink at the oh shit. Oh fuck. Oh god. Oh gee. Okay, alright, okay. Alright, 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 alright. I'll be off. Okay, alright, I'll go. Stop fucking around.
I'm bored. The open sea calls. Yeah.
We'll go get a cannon.
Well, I think the,
I'll tell you what I know about how to navigate way up there. The sea chart of the northern, northwestern sea covers the whole area north up there, up here. So, draw a course to the top of our chart until you see the northwestern sea. After we reach it, you can draw our next leg on the northwestern sea chart. Neat, right? Right?
I think what's happening, Mad Guy, is I think the DB barrier to reach a low is so insanely high that I have to peak my microphone in order to make it happen. I think that's what's happening. Can't read it from here? That is crazy. Okay. Edo's garage. Oh, this is Edo! Okay. We've already done this. I just didn't come back here when we were redoing stuff because I forgot that I did in the first time, but we've already done this.
Welcome to Edo's garage. That is Master Edo's shop. I'm Fuzo, his apprentice. And you? Oh, nice to meet you, Splunk. What? You want a cannon? Sorry, little guy, but we don't have any ready to sell.
Reminds me of when I would play Fire Emblem Fates on the public transport, and I would have to blow into my microphone to cool off some character that just got done with a shower or something. Nodders cheer 500.
Master's working on one, though, so he's withdrawn in his workroom. Very interesting. Thank you for the 500 bits, too. Fire Emblem Fates. Is that the one with the dragons? Well, they all have dragons. Is that the one where you play as the person that could transform into a dragon? Is that the one?
Master's working on one, though, so he's withdrawn to his workroom. Yeah, he's gone and locked himself in there until he's done concentrating. If you really, really want a cannon, then go speak with the master. You can go around the island to reach the back door. Dangerous, though. A back door is never locked, so that's your ticket to meet the master. All you have to open the gate that leads to the rest of the island. Follow me.
Be a fortune amid the beehives.
Will we get a cannon? Will we be able to shoot the golden frog with it? What is in the Northwestern Sea? Find out next time on The Legend of Zelda and an Hourglass.